Welcome you all to intro class on direct taxation. I am Shiv Kumar, assistant professor, Department of Management Sciences, Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. Today's session contents are as follows. We'll be discussing regarding college vision, college mission, department mission, and course introduction. First thing is college vision. To be recognized as a premier technical and management institution promoting extensive education, fostering research, innovation, and entrepreneurial attitude. College mission, to empower students with indispensable knowledge through dedicated teaching and collaborative learning. To advance extensive research in science, engineering, and management disciplines. To facilitate entrepreneurial skills through effective institute-industry collaboration and interaction with alumni. To instill the need to upload ethics in every aspects. To mold holistic individual capable of contributing to the advancement of the society. Next thing is department vision. To contribute the nation with disciplined, responsible, professional and skilled management graduates. Our department mission provide excellence management education for rural and urban students, empowering them with capability to become valuable citizens, contributing continuously to global business management. We all remember this, okay? We move on to the subject now. This is not a new subject, as we might be studied in our degree classes. It might be new for the science and engineering graduates. So, as you study the direct taxation as one of the elective for the finance specialization, more than anything, as a citizen of the country, it is our responsibility to know about taxation in our day-to-day life. So what is taxation or tax? Tax, in the sense, a compulsory payment towards the government without any direct return in benefit to pay is known as tax. So it is an important source for the government, which will be collected by three authorities: central government, state government, and local authorities. So what are the objectives of this tax? The objectives of this tax are: it reduces gap between the rich and poor, it enables the government to maintain law and order and safeguard security of the country for the foreign power, it helps in providing infrastructure facilities to our welfare activities of the people like road, irrigation facilities, etc. It also provides entrepreneurial opportunities, it helps us achieve balanced socio-economic growth. Before going to in-depth of your subject, we need to know the difference between what is tax and what is taxation. First thing is, what is tax? As I earlier quoted, it is a compulsory financial charge or some type of levy that will be imposed on a taxpayer by the governmental organization in order to fund various public expenditures. What is taxation? Taxation, it is a practice by the government where they will be collecting the tax from the citizens to pay the public services. Without taxation, there is no would be public liberty, libraries or parks or extra infrastructure facilities. Next thing is moving on to taxation in India. So here, Indian tax structure is divided into direct taxes and indirect taxes. First thing is, what do you mean by direct taxes? Direct taxes are levied on a taxable income earned by an individuals or the corporate entities. It will be a burden for an individual where, without getting any benefit directly, he has to pay the tax for the government. So authority monitoring this direct taxes is CBDT, that is Central Board of Direct Taxes. Next thing is indirect taxes. So indirect taxes are levied on the sales or the goods what we purchase or the what is the services we expect. So it is a burden on the seller who will be collecting the taxes from the person who is purchasing the product or service and hand it over to the government authorities. So here, taxation in India will be levied by the central government as well as state government, where, which is also said, some of the minor taxes will also be levied by the local authorities, such as municipalities or local governments. So which are the major taxes that are levied here? One is income tax. Next thing is central goods and service tax. Next thing, custom duty. Next thing is integrated goods and services tax. Major state taxes are SGST, that is state government and state taxes. Next is stamp duty and registration. So well, now hope you are understood about what is tax or taxation in a brief about. Next, I'll take you to the syllabus what we will be discussing in your third semester. So the subject, as I earlier said, it is direct taxation, where you'll be studying in your third semester. The subject code is 18 MBA FM 303. So your complete course will be of 100 marks, where it will be split into internals 40 marks as well as external 60 marks. So as you know, all the semesters you have come across with 6 units. Here also in your direct taxation, you will be going with 6 units. So before I go with what are the 6 units we will be discussing, so I'll come up with in the tax, what are the things that will be covered here. So first and foremost thing, you need to know the 5 heads of income which are involved with your taxation aspect. One is income from salary, income from house property, income from business or profession, income from capital gain, income from other sources. These are the 5 heads of income what as an individual we should know. These 5 heads are compiled and combined with all these 6 units what you will be studying in your direct taxation. Now I will take you through each unit, what are the things or what are the aspects you will be studying over here. Unit 1. So first and foremost thing, in your unit 1 we will discuss about Indirect Taxation Act, that is 1961, what it is all about. Next thing, we come across basic concepts and definitions related to your tax. Also we discuss capital expenditure and capital receipts, capital revenue, basis of charge, scope of total income. Most important thing or most important aspect what we will be discussing here with respect to even your from your examination viewpoint is your residential status and incidence of tax. Next thing also we come across income which do not form your total income under section 10. And also we discuss about tax planning, tax evasion and tax management. And the numerical problems which are involved in this unit will be purely based on your residential status of an individual. Next, moving on to unit 2. So here in your unit 2, we will come across 2 things, that is one is income from salary, income from house property. So here related to your income from salary, you will be learning about meaning of salary, about allowances, what are the valuation aspect, what are the taxable perquisites, what is death cum retirement benefit, what are the deductions that will be given towards your salary. And next aspect is income from house property, where you will be coming across only theoretical aspect, but the numerical problems that will be discussed here will be related to your income from salary. Next, moving on to unit 3, introduction. So here in your unit 3, you will be reading about or studying about income under head profit and gains of business or profession. So where you will be making the computation related to the incomes what you will be earning through your business or earning through your profession, where we come across computation of your business and profession. Also, what are the methods that are adopted in accounting schemes to make your business deductions as well as allowances, and also how the maintenance of books will be done in your organizations. Next, also we discuss about depreciation related aspects, and also main thing here is computation of income from business or profession of an individual assessee will be assessed over here, where you'll study the numerical problems based on the depreciation as well as an individual who is doing business related to that, as well as an individual profession. For example, it might be a doctor, it might be an engineer, like that you will be studying in your unit 3. Next, moving on to unit 4, you will be learning here about 2 aspects here also, that is one is income under your capital gain, another one is your income from other sources. Under income from capital gain, you learn about what are the charges that will be levied, how it will the capital gain will be calculated, what are the transfer of capital assets, what do you mean by capital assets, what are the inclusions, what are the exclusions that you come across will be discussed here, and majorly the problems will be based on your capital gain. Next thing is income from other sources, the theoretical concepts will be discussed in your fourth module. This is overall of your fourth unit. Next, moving on to unit 5, that is where you will come across the permissible deductions under section 80C and 80U, which is most essential for your subject, where it might be any edge of your income you will be calculating. These permissible deductions are very essential and very important. So where also in your unit 5, we also discuss about computation of tax liability of an individual. Adding on to this, we also discuss about set off and carry forward losses. Theoretical aspects will be discussed in your unit 5. Next, moving on to unit 6, here we will be reading about MAT. So what do you mean by MAT? Here, MAT in the sense minimum alternative tax. So where the computation of an individual or the company will be with respect to or with special reference to MAT will be discussed over here. The numerical problems will be based on your minimum alternative tax. So this is overall of your unit 6. In total of all these 6 units will be covering all these 5 heads of your income, that is income from salary, income from house property, income from business or profession, income from capital gain, income from other sources. So overall you will be discussing your 6 units, or we will be studying 6 units in this overall course. Your question paper will be of pattern of where it will be covering 30% of your theory as well as 70% of your numerical problems, where you should give your emphasis towards both theory as well as the problems, because theory is a base for doing your problems. You have to concentrate on your theoretical aspects as well as your problem also. Next thing, so now you are clear with what are the units you will be studying in this course. Next, after studying these courses, so there should be some outcome which you will be coming out, or you will be saying that yes, I learned that from this subject, I learned this. So what are those things you will be learning out of this? So where we will be claiming it as a COs or the course outcomes. So where you will be in here, it will be involved with 4 COs with respect to this subject. One is, that is your CO1, where it will be saying as understanding computation of direct taxes, means related to your direct taxes, what are the computations you will be making, you will be understanding through this first CO. Second CO is where you will be analyzing the complexities involved in your assessment of tax liabilities with respect to your individuals, with respect to your HUF, company, firm, association of person and local authority. Next thing is CO3, evaluates the process of filing your income tax returns of an individual, partnership firm and companies. Next, CO4 will be saying about how you will be designing your tax planning as well as taxpayers distinguished by the sources of incomes. So now you have got a glimpse of direct taxation, what you will be reading in your third semester. So probably the new subject, it will be said as new subject for the engineering students as well as those who are from science background. There is no hard and harsh rule that it is difficult, nothing like that. It will be taking towards the easily aspects we will be making you understand through the problems, through the numerical problems also. Hope you all have got the glimpse of direct taxation. So keeping this as a base, in the further classes we will be going with unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, like that. It will be following on and we will be making you understand with these aspects of your direct taxation. In depth of that aspects will be studied in your finance specialization, where you have chosen your finance specialization as a thing. So thank you all for listening to me. Thank you all.